गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल मैथ्स क्लासेस बाय जोइता। वी आर लर्निंग द कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑलरेडी डन, आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू फ्रॉम दैट ओनली। सो व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड इन द लास्ट क्लास, दैट वाज द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन टू पॉइंट्स पी एंड क्यू, दैट वाज एक्स टू माइनस एक्स वन होल स्क्वायर प्लस वाई टू माइनस वाई वन होल स्क्वायर। नाउ देयर आर फ्यू केसेस। Suppose one is the origin. Here both the points are arbitrary points, right? Suppose we are taking one point is origin. I am taking x2, q as origin. So that means coordinate will be 0, 0. So what will be the distance between p and q? P is same as usual, x1, y1. So distance between p and q will be square root of x2. X2 was there, x2 means here 0. Minus x1 square plus 0 minus y1 square. Okay, so that means x1 square plus y1 square. So when you need to find any point distance from origin, you can directly use this formula. Whatever coordinate will be given, you just need to do the squares and need to take the square root after that. Sum of the squares and then square root. Okay. Next the thing is, one more thing here, square root is there. So we know both the values will come. That is plus or minus sign should come, right? So both the values we need to take. But the distance cannot be negative. So that always positive part is considered. That's what here I have put modulus. Okay. And the next thing, suppose both the points are on x axis. Here, both the points are on arbitrary coordinates, means they both have coordinate x1 and y1. Suppose this p and q both are on x axis. That means what? Coordinate will be x1, 0 and q coordinate will be x2, 0. Because on x axis y coordinate is 0, equation is y is equal to 0, equation of the x axis. Then what will be the distance between these? We directly take the modulus between this because they both are on same line. Okay. I am taking one example. Suppose here one point is there, that is 2, 0. Here the point is 4, 0. What will be the distance between this and this? We will just subtract the coordinate, x coordinate. That is modulus of 4 minus 2. 2 in it, distance will be, so the same thing here also will be applied, that will be modulus of x2 minus x1. You can take x1 minus x2 also because we are taking modulus, so the absolute value will come out. Same thing whenever points will be on y axis, 0, y1, 0, y2. Okay, so here also it will be mod of y1 minus y2 or y2 minus y1. Okay guys, I hope you all understood the distance formula and their cases. Okay, and the next thing I will take, I will prove some questions, means I will solve some questions, in that some proof also there. So just see, if I was talking about this question, I will prove here this question. What is telling, that is in a triangle ABC, given is the O is the middle point of BC, and you need to prove that AB square plus AC square equal to 2 times of OA square plus OB square. Okay. So first I am taking O as an origin also, and it is given that O is the middle point of BC. Right. So first I am drawing the rectangular coordinate system. Okay. So here that O is the middle point of BC. So that means B and C also will be lying on x axis. Because O is on x-axis. So here B, here C. I am taking BC at any length. Let BC is equal to 2k. Anything you can take. Not only k. So that means what will be the coordinate for B and C? This is minus k, 0. This is k, 0. Because we have read previously. Before this question, and I have told distance between two points on x axis, this minus of this, right? Now, for A point, we don't have any information, so I can take anywhere in the coordinate system. So I'm taking on first quadrant. Alpha comma beta. Okay. Now we need to prove this expression. So for this thing, I'll prove left hand side separately and right hand side separately. I will calculate basically. If both are equal, then we can say our question is done. Okay. So first I'm calculating left hand side. That is AB square plus AC square. Before calculating left hand side, I'm finding out the AB. AB square and AC square. So we need to use only the distance formula. A is alpha comma beta, B is minus k comma 0. So our formula was x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square under root. So here alpha plus a square plus beta minus 0 square. So that is ab square will be, under root will remove, that is alpha plus a square plus beta square. Okay. Similarly, ac square, here alpha, beta and k comma 0. So in place of plus k, it will be minus k. That is alpha minus k square plus beta square. Okay. Now I am calculating LHS. That is AB square plus AC square. So alpha plus k square plus beta square plus alpha minus k square plus beta square. I am breaking this expression, that formula. Alpha square plus 2 alpha k plus k square plus beta square plus alpha square minus 2 alpha k plus k square plus beta square. So 2 alpha k will cancel out. 2 times of alpha square plus beta square plus k square. Now we calculate RHS. So OA means from O to A. O coordinate we know, that is 0 comma 0. So OA square will be alpha square plus beta square, because from origin distance formula was just square of these coordinates, sum of them and then under root. But here OA square is there. So RHS is equal to 2 times of OA square plus OB square. That means 2 times of alpha square plus beta square. Now OB, here minus k comma 0. So that is k square only. 0 minus of minus k whole square, that means plus k whole square. So see this. Here our LHS value was 2 times of alpha square plus beta square plus k square. RHS value is also 2 times of alpha square plus beta square plus k square. So this is equal to RHS equal to LHS. So it's proved. I hope it's clear for everyone. We'll do one more problem. Okay. Let's see the second question. Question is, let A equal to 3 comma 4 and B is a variable point on the lines mod x equal to 6. Okay. If AB is less than or equal to 4, then the number of position of B with integral coordinates is options are there. This is the MCQ questions. First of all, what you can understand from this question, we are having one point A. I am just drawing the rough diagram. Okay, so here 3, 4. 3 comma 4 is here. So that means A point is here. Okay, next is B is lying on mod x is equal to 6. So if we will break the mod x, we will get x is equal to plus or minus 6. So B coordinate can be plus or minus 6 comma y, because we don't have any information about the y coordinate. Only lying on this straight line. So first I am taking the positive side. Then that means what will be? Y can be anywhere. So I am taking here 6 comma y. This is we need to find this AB. And then condition is there. From there we need to find the integral coordinates for that y, basically position of B. So x coordinate is given, we need to find the y only. So and if it will be minus x comma y, this side it will be. So from here to here we need to find the distance. So I'm taking the plus minus 6 at a time and I'm finding AB. AB is equal to square root of थ्री माइनस ऑफ प्लस माइनस सिक्स होल स्क्वायर प्लस फोर माइनस वाई होल स्क्वायर. ओके सो हियर माइनस इज देयर, हियर प्लस माइनस इज देयर, सो इट विल बी चेंज, माइनस प्लस इट विल बी, माइनस प्लस इट विल बी माइनस, माइनस माइनस प्लस. सो देन द नेक्स्ट स्टेप वी कैन राइट थ्री माइनस प्लस सिक्स होल स्क्वायर प्लस फोर माइनस वाई स्क्वायर. ओके सो इफ विल टेक द पॉजिटिव कोऑर्डिनेट वॉट द वैल्यूज विल कम, वैल्यू विल बी थ्री माइनस सिक्स. फर्स्ट आई एम टेकिंग थ्री माइनस सिक्स, नेगेटिव साइन आई विल राइट हियर, टेकिंग नेगेटिव साइन. सो थ्री माइनस सिक्स दैट मीन्स थ्री होल स्क्वायर, सो नाइन प्लस फोर माइनस वाई स्क्वायर, एंड अगेन दिस थिंग विल बी थ्री प्लस सिक्स दैट मीन्स नाइन स्क्वायर, सो 81 प्लस फोर माइनस वाई होल स्क्वायर, टेकिंग पॉजिटिव साइन. ओके हियर टेकिंग नेगेटिव साइन, टेकिंग पॉजिटिव साइन. नेक्स्ट विल बी ए बी इज लेस देन और इक्वल टू फोर, सो दैट I'll take both the coordinates and will show. First of all, this thing will not be applicable as, see, if we'll take the square root of 81 plus 4 minus y whole square less than or equal to 4. If we'll take y equal to 0, we don't know y value. So if y equal to 0, what it will be? 81 plus 16 square root of this, obviously greater than 4. So it cannot be less than or equal to 4. So this choice is gone from here. We need to take this thing. Okay. So here this possibility already we have cancelled. So next is AB is less than or equal to 4. So that means square root of 9 plus 4 minus y whole square less than or equal to 4. So I'm making square both sides. So that will be 9 plus 16. Okay. Okay, so this side it will be 9 plus 16 minus 8y plus y square less than or equal to 16. 16 will get cancelled both sides. So y square minus 8y plus 9 less than or equal to 0. Okay, so here if we will check that it will not break, we cannot find this thing from middle term factor because it is the negative square, discriminant is negative. This term is 4 is if you can calculate 64 minus, it's positive only, but it will not, we cannot break this thing middle term by middle term. Okay, so we have to do the factorization thing. So I'll use the Schwitter criterion here and then the Weyl curve method. So minus b plus minus root over b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. 64 minus 36, 8, 28 by 2. So 8 plus minus 2 root 7 by 2. So that is 4 plus minus root 7. Okay? 4 plus minus root 7. So that means y curve means it will go this way. Here it will be 4 minus root 7. Here 4 plus root 7. So it is y minus. So directly we can write from here. We know these are the factors only. These are the roots. So we can directly write 4 minus root 7 less than or equal to y less than or equal to 4 plus root 7. Okay. Now the thing is like root 7 means you need to find the integral values. So for integral values, what we need to do? We just need only the integers thing. So we know square root of 4 is 2. Square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 7 will be in between 2 and 3 only. So I am assuming suppose 2.5. More than 2 basically. Approximately 2.5. Then it will be greater than 1.5. Less than or equal to this. And this is 6.5. So what are the integers in between 1.5 and 6.5? Y equal to 2, 3, 4 5, 6. 5 values we will get. So our integral value, number of position position of b with respect to the integer values, that is 5. Answer will be 5. So option was, I think, A. Yeah. So guys, that's it for today. We'll make next video. In the next video, I'll teach the area of triangle, and there are some applications also. And please like, comment, and subscribe my channel. And if possible, if you want any other chapters or any other questions, you can send me in comment box. Thank you. Thanks for watching.